Okay, so we are continuing with chapter 2. In this video, I'm going to show you how to be able to take a problem and find a solution for it. So we want to be able to, if you read up here, get the radius of a circle from the user and write a program to calculate the area and circumference of the circle. That's what we need to do. So if you look at your assignments, there are questions like this which tell you what you're given and what you need to do to in your program. For us, the goals for this program and the things that are in chapter 2 are we want to be able to define the variables and figure out what type of data are they going to hold, so that way we can define the data types for those variables. And we are also going to see how to use constants. Anytime it's appropriate, you must use constants. Then we're going to calculate the data, which is nothing but area and circumference in this case, and output it to the user. So we're going to start out by doing our include. And in this case, we don't need any string, so I'm not going to include string. Using namespace std, then we are going to go right into our program. And we said define variables. So the first question is, how many variables do we need and what are they? So it says get the radius of a circle from the user. So we know we need one to hold the radius. Now, what kind of a data type do we want radius to be? So if we say int, it's going to be able to hold only whole numbers, and that would be very limiting. So we want to be able to use a double, or you can use a float. So we can use a double radius, and we always initialize it to something, zero in this case, because eventually we're going to read it from the user. We also need some variables to hold the area and circumference that we are going to calculate. And they are also going to be doubles. So I'm going to create area equals zero, comma. Notice we separate all these variables by comma, and they're all doubles. Circumference equals zero. So we have three variables. Now, we also must go up here in our comments, and by this time, you need to figure out, before you start writing code, you need to figure out the formula for your area and circumference. So we all know area equals pi times r times r, or pi r square. And we know circumference. You want to make sure you figure this out before you start writing your code. So when you start writing your code, you can actually go ahead and do it. So 2 times pi times r. So now the pi, we all know, is a constant. So the best thing to do for your pi, instead of coming in here and simply using pi as 3.14159 in your program, the right thing to do is to come here and declare some constants. Now notice my constants go outside of main, and I call them global constants because pi is not going to change once we define it, and we want to make sure that we are going to use the same pi through the rest of the program. So I'm going to call my constant const double. We don't want our const pi to be an int. And notice I capitalize all my constants, and 3.14159. It's best to have at least 5 digits after the decimal to be able to get a better area and circumference, or whatever it is that we are calculating. If you stop with 3.14, then we don't get as much precision. So, and you can always add a few more digits if you want to. You can go to pi.com and take a look at it and add a few more digits, but we don't have to for this program. So once we have pi defined, we have our variables declared, our next step is to read from the user. So we want to read the radius from the user. So you have your prompt, and you say, please enter the radius of the circle. Important to have our prompts very clear so the user knows exactly what we are looking for. It's also important to name your variables appropriately. We don't want to call them XYZ or ABCD. So we're going to read it into radius. There is my radius, C in radius. Now we are going to calculate area and circumference. So I'm going to say area equals, and we have the formula up there, pi times r. In our case, it would be pi is my constant, just the way I have it, times, we don't have an r, we have a radius, so we're going to use radius times radius. And there is my area, and I'm going to say circumference equals 2 times, notice I have my spacing in between all my operators, so this is a good example for you to follow for your style guidelines, 2 times pi times r, and that's it. Now we output to the user. And again, outputting to the user, you can make it a lot nicer. You can say cout area equals, and we called it area. And you can always say square units, because that's what it is. And you must have a space before the square. And of course, we must, at the end of it, have a new line, end line, and then see out. Now, if you want, you can copy that and paste it here, but we have to change a few things. Instead of area, I'm going to say circumference, and I'm going to copy that circumference. So, circumference equals, and here's circumference, and of course that's just units. Circumference is not square units, so simply say units, and then that's it, and then return zero. We'll finish our program. So it's a very simple program. Let's build it. That shows you how to approach a given problem. So define the variables first. Figure out what kind of variables you need and what data types they're going to be and where you're going to store the result. Then decide what you're going to get from the user, what you're going to use as constants, and then figure out your formula for what you need to calculate, and then output to the user. So let's see if it comes out the way we want it to be. So if I say 2.5, then you get area and circumference. Now it's best to verify these answers with a calculator to make sure that you actually get the right answers, and it's very important to do that. As I will show you in the next chapter, we could have some potential errors where we may not get the same values as you get from the calculator, and you'll notice that there are some errors that can happen on our program. So make sure you verify some of these with a calculator.